He said he was down with it.
You with Damian?
Yeah.
Oh, I knew that. I knew that. See, the thing is with 2/3, they can't separate truth from falsehood. They don't got that chip in them. You know what I'm saying? They can't separate wickedness from righteousness. You know, they can't discern the difference between the both. So they accept all these motherfuckers, you know. ISUPK, Cuffies groups, whoever the fuck. I don't even know the acronyms of all them groups no more, man. But they can't, they don't know the difference. They don't know
the
difference.
They said they was talking shit about GMS.
Oh my God.
Didn't they? They said it was evil or something. What did he say?
He said his name's evil or something like that.
Great Millstone?
He said the name.
That's spiritual then, because Great Millstone is going to be wrapped around their neck and be thrown in the ocean.
Oh, yeah.
Smash. That's an instrument they use for destroying shit.
The Most High said when they destroy America. Hey, let's get that Revelation 18. Oh, you got something, bring it out.
Yeah, I'm going to get that.
He's already got
all these heathens. This is 2nd Ezra. 2nd Ezra 3:36. Thou shalt find that Israel by name hath kept thy precepts, but not the heathen. Mm.
So they can be saved, huh? They don't give a damn about the laws or what the fuck ever. They're following some of the laws, but they follow some of them. You know, because it benefits them above and that.
But how you gonna have how you gonna teach that heathens can be saved? And then you got someone in your congregation, you call him your brother, then you gonna call him Esau. Mm. Or you gonna call your brother Ham. That's like an insult to your brother, ain't it? Isn't that an insult?
Totally disrespect.
How can you gonna call your brother Ham or Esau?
That's totally disrespect.
Amen. That's disrespect. Yeah, because Esau, the scriptures say Esau's a profane person. So when we have somebody in our camp, we started calling him, y'all, he's an Edomite. This dude's feeling bad. He's like, I'm a profane person.
Profane, all of the above, the border of wickedness.
He might take that profane as a compliment.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you know what? They just might.
Man, I was looking for a good scripture. I was reading it earlier. I can't find it.
Yeah, Israel wicked and more wicked than other nation, man. By the way, they act, we tell him that he don't have that shit. It's one thing they're trying to do, man. They're trying to avoid getting a camera getting cut the fuck up, and they're gonna say no. They know we're exposing their hustle, man. They know it. That's why they ain't coming out here no more. They're fucking 500 deep. Fuck
the Raza. The last time I seen Peraza, he gave me a ride. So he was being nice. I mean, he's a nice guy. He might do some good stuff and help people out, but he's not teaching the truth. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna sit up here and lie and say he's teaching the truth when he's not. But that teaching that heathens can be saved is not the truth. Teaching that you gotta love everybody is not the truth. Teaching that there's such thing as hell is not the truth. Teaching that the Sabbath is on Saturn's day. It's on Friday sundown to Saturday sundown. That's not the truth. The Sabbath is not on Saturn's day, okay? The Bible does not use a Gregorian calendar. So that's not the truth. What else? Going out teaching strapped with pistols and firearms. That's not the truth.
Yeah, they carnal as fuck. They carnal. They carnal, man.
That's no faith.
They ain't got faith unless they're 50 deep. You know about that nigga in the hood that's 50 deep and he's all the main one talking shit.
Oh, yeah.
How hard he is, how mad he is and shit. That's a carnal motherfucker.
Yeah, going out and teaching just in the hood is not the truth.
You gotta be strapped.
Yeah, what kind of faith is that?
Right.
So, yeah. You gotta watch out. You know, you gotta watch who you following. You can't be following anybody. I'm still trying to find that scripture. I was reading this morning. I can't find it now. I'm going to get it, though. Hold on.
In the Facebook page said that he had a great day of teaching, a great day of...
The great day of the Sabbath.
Something like
he
that.
He said it was a great Sabbath.
Something like that. Yeah, that's right.
There's your boy. Hey, there's your boy. He loves everybody, too. He should go, you know, join up forces with Peraza.
The forces of Peraza.
Matthew 15 and 22. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil. But he answered her not a word.
So, homie, God loves you. He loves you, man.
I'm gonna start on Matthew 15 and 22. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with the devil. But he answered her not a word. And the disciples came and besought him, saying, send her away, for she cried after us. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Yeah, what does that mean? When he said, I'm not sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
It's only sent to the children of Israel.
That's us. That's us.
Well, at that time, he was talking about the Israelites who live in the state of Israel.
The Lord said the Most High don't change.
So you saying now, they don't reply?
Well, the new government replies.
That's in the New Testament.
Okay, he agreed.
Well, he can't. All he tells the woman, she has great faith because it says that she's a Canaanite.
But she persevered. She persevered and got her blessing from the Lord.
Because he said, great is your faith.
Right.
But what people don't understand.
What did he first tell her? What did he first tell the woman?
He told her that it's not good to, you know, to give your pearls on the swine.
Well, no. He said it's not good for you to eat bread off the children's dog.
Oh, yeah, excuse me. Yeah, that same thing. But what she didn't know, what a lot of people don't actually know, is that she might have been thought she was a Canaanite, but she was actually an Israelite. And that's why the Lord, you know, says she had great faith.
You know about Israel being scattered, right?
No. What it really means is, man, that woman wasn't of the house of Israel. Wasn't one of the children of Israel.
She is, though.
Wait a minute. She wasn't. But what happened, though, is even though the Lord first told her no, you know what I'm saying, she persevered. And she trusted and she believed in God.
Yeah, she had faith.
And she persevered through his first no. And then she got her blessing from the Lord. So basically what the Lord is saying is this. God loves everybody, brother. He loves everybody.
He don't love everybody.
Hey, look, bro, listen. I know what that book says. I know that book from in and out.
Did you know this book also is a stumbling block to 2000? This is a stumbling block.
You know
what a stumbling block is?
It
means you're going to be tripping over everything.
All right, bro. He just wants to say Jesus loves everybody and to close the book.
Right.
Jesus loves you.
That's he's stumbling all over the book.
That second answer is 3:36.
Hey, yo, I got a lesson.
I'm glad he left.
Yeah, the heathen don't keep. Man, they, you know, that's something.
Just go back and check out what we're
talking about.
I just read that scripture before you.
Yeah, right.
For this very topic right here, it's a spiritual thing that, you know, he came up while we was talking about it. Is this very topic is the main topic that people get bugged out on. Nobody can understand it. It's so simple, yet nobody can understand that Israel is scattered among all nations.
That's right.
Peraza them, they can't get it. They can't see it. The ISUPKs, they don't get it. The IUIC, they claim they get it. They don't get it. They pretend like they get it sometimes. They don't get it. The only people teaching it was GMS. And the people want to bad-mouth them. Like you said, Peraza was bad-mouthing GMS, right? That's not cool, man. They the only ones teaching the truth, and you're going to speak evil about them. You know what I mean?
That's right. Here you go, bro. This is Malachi 3:6. For I am the Lord. I change not.
Yeah, the Lord don't change, and his son is his main representative. So the Lord don't change. If he said, I come not for the lost sheep of Israel, he ain't come but for Israel.
I change not, therefore ye sons of Jacob are not consumed.
So the reason he don't change is so Jacob is not consumed. It didn't say so the heathens ain't consumed.
The heathens.
Man, you think this is so simple to us. You know, when you
ain't it?
But to these fools,
they can't see it.
They can't see it. It's amazing that they can't see it.
It ain't
meant. Hebrews 13. And 8. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, and today, and forever.
What did I read that again?
Hebrews 13 and 8. I'm saying his Greek name just for.
Oh yeah, that's cool.
Jesus, Hebrews 13 and 8. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, and today, and forever.
Same during the Old Testament.
I thought he changed though.
See,
there was a point in time when, see, they had made a change though.
This person that said that, oh, that applied back then. I'm gonna ask them, all right, so what year and date and time did it not matter anymore?
Yeah, give me a date.
Give me a date. Yeah, since they know that it don't matter now, they must know a date where it all changed. 1776.
So that's a date for everything. That's a date the Illuminati was founded.
That's what I'm saying.
What was that, May? I don't forget. What was that, May 4th? Or
July the 4th, 1776.
No, that was America, but it was in May when the Illuminati was started.
I
used to have it memorized. They talked about it so long. Yeah, that's funny how the Illuminati was formed by Adam Weishaupt the same year America was formed. Mm-hmm. That's a coincidence.
So the Lord gonna wake up one day and just all the teachings he taught is gonna be told and changed and thrown out the window.
Right.
People have lost their goddamn mind. Lost their goddamn mind. And the Lord, you gonna put a can of whoop ass on
his feet. Yeah. Stumbling
on the mind. Wait a minute, don't the scripture say don't meddle with a man given to change?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
we gotta leave the Lord alone since he.
Yeah.
You know,
he's changing all the time. He changes so much.
You know, this is crazy, man.
He said, leave the Lord alone.
Yeah, it's a change. It's so true.
People done bugged the fuck out, man.
That's the reason why
you might want to wipe your forehead
right now,
off.
I got some mommy.
He's probably keeping it original.
No, he's keeping it real.
What the hell was that?
It looks like a burger.
A booger? There ain't no booger.
This is John 5:45. Do not think that I will accuse you to the Father. There is one that accuses of you, even Moses, in whom ye trust. For had ye believed Moses, you would have believed me, for he wrote of me. But if ye believe not his writings, how shall ye believe my words?
How can you, if you don't believe what Moses said, then what did Moses say? Now, Moses said the same thing to the Lord. Hey, get Deuteronomy 30, because this actually go right into what Moses was saying. Moses said the same thing as the Lord. He said Israel was scattered. Right?
Yeah.
And that's the New Testament too, he says that. The whole New Testament, he tells you, remember Moses.
So that's why he said, if you don't believe Moses, how you gonna believe me? Right?
With the top?
Yeah, it's like four scriptures.
Okay, Deuteronomy 30:1. And it shall come to pass, when all these things are come upon thee, the blessings and the curse, which I have set before thee, and thou shalt call them to mind among all the nations, whither the Lord thy power hath driven thee, and shalt return unto the Lord thy power, and shalt obey his voice according to all that I command thee this day, thou and thy children, with all thine heart and with all thy soul, that then the Lord thy power will turn thy captivity and have compassion upon thee, and will return and gather thee from all the nations whither the Lord thy power have scattered thee.
Why do you say that? He said Israel is scattered among all the nations. Keep going.
If any of thine be driven out unto the outmost parts of heaven, from thence will the Lord thy power gather thee, and from thence will he fetch thee. And the Lord thy power will bring thee into the land which thy fathers possessed, and thou shalt possess it, and he will do thee good and multiply thee above thy fathers. And the Lord thy power will circumcise thy heart and the heart of thy seed to love the Lord thy power with all thine heart and with all thy soul, that thou mayest live. And the Lord thy power will put all these curses upon thy enemies, and on them that hate thee will persecute thee. And thou shalt return and obey the voice of the Lord and do all his commandments, which I have commanded thee this day.
So that's the point, yeah, because you read that, he said, all right, during the last days, when the last days come around, which is now, the Lord's going to start gathering Israel back together, and he's going to put them back into their own land.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
The gathering starts with his elect. Gathering out here on these streets.
Everybody, you know, you always got people They so simple minded, so they small minded. They don't think big enough. Cause they got peanut sized brains, and they think that Israel is just this small little tiny little group of people over here. Now these are just Israelites, and people don't understand that Israel is massive. Israel is innumerable. It's unfathomable how many Israelites there are. It'll boggle your brains.
You know what I'm saying?
Because Israel is innumerable. There's more Israelites than any other nation, and we scatter. But you know, you can't teach a fool. A fool ain't gonna get it. Most people just ain't gonna get it. They ain't gonna understand it. Good for them. You know, we're gonna mark them and stay away from them.
This is Deuteronomy 32:8-28. For they are a nation void of counsel, neither is there any understanding in them.
Yeah. That's most people that believe in the Bible. Because you got a lot of people that believe in this book. They start up in a little crazy ass church, be teaching their bugged out doctrine. You know what I'm saying? But they'll never get the truth. But that's good for them. And you know, if you ain't noticed, most people that teach the Bible are fucking, they're crazy. They're a bunch of weirdos. You know what I mean? That's like one of the things about the Bible. The Bible does attract some weird people, man. But you know, and then they read the Bible without studying. And the Spirit of the Lord ain't with them. And they just start coming out with all kind of bugged out shit. You know what I'm saying?
This is weird.
You don't see it at all.
How would you save your enemy, man? I just don't. I mean, that's just mind-boggling itself.
Yeah, that's mind-boggling.
You know?
Well, the Lord said he gonna separate the sheep from the goats. Yeah. That don't make sense.
It's been throughout. That's what I'm saying. All this shit. Soon as a fucking America gets built up, all this shit. Because before this place, everybody was on that shit, like I-49-242. You know?
Yep.
And all of a sudden, when this place get built up, everything's all changed
love.
Up.
It's all love.
It's
all love. It's everybody. Let me see you drive through New Albany. You know what I'm saying? Let me see you drive through New Albany, see how comfortable you feel.
Oh,
Belton.
Yeah. Bexley. You know,
right.
Walk through Bexley.
Right. Yeah,
shit.
Walk through Bexley.
You know what's even worse is Grove City.
Oh, yeah.
Stay away from that motherfucking place.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck that shit.
I ain't that far from Grove City.
Oh, fuck. Don't even go near
it. I did a couple moves out there. Yeah.
Man, it was the worst cops in the whole whole county.
They shady.
Hey, you know, there's a Whitehall cop. Did I tell y'all that last week? A Whitehall cop shot a little girl.
Yeah, straight, yeah.
You see that?
Yep.
So, yeah, there's some Whitehall cops are assholes, too. Shot a little girl last week. Because he said a dog was coming at him.
Wow.
What a fucking coward. Have you ever thought about shooting a dog? Kick a dog or punch a dog,
right,
shoot a dog.
No.
And I bet you it was a chihuahua.
Some little shit, yeah.
An ankle biter.
Go ahead.
Hebrews 4:12. For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of thoughts and intents of the heart.
Yeah, that's why a lot of people, they don't want to debate with us. You know what I mean? Because they know we'll start chopping them up with this sword right here. Anybody that comes out debates us or attempt to debate, there's no debate. Comes out here, what are you doing is just scoffing. But there is no debate.
Yeah, there is no debate. Because you had me bring out research to this idiot the other couple weeks back about the word religion.
Oh, yeah.
They wasn't even listening.
They didn't want to hear it.
They didn't want him to hear it.
Because it takes a real man to admit when he's wrong on something.
Yeah.
You know? And just to shut it down. Like, oh shit, I just need to shut down, and shut up, and listen to these men, because they know what they're talking about.
Yeah, you know, you think I gave up a fight when I believed in them shapeshifters and shit before the truth? You think I gave up a fight to leave that shit alone, man?
Oh yeah, same thing.
Shapeshifters.
Shapeshifters.
I mean, they act like shapeshifters, but
shapeshifters, the merfolk. the Grays. You want some bugged out shit?
That's some bugged out shit.
I was listening to Jeff Rentz. I was listening to the Rentz radio, and he had some dude on the show talking about UFOs. And he said, if you want to keep the gray aliens away from you, just get some borax and sprinkle borax all around your house. Because he said the grays are insect-based life form, and they're afraid of borax. So you gonna tell me some technologically advanced alien species you can easily defeat them with a $2 bottle of borax?
That's old too, man. They've been teaching that.
I never heard that.
Yeah, that's old, man.
Man, that blew my mind when I heard that.
Anybody heard of Sherry Schreiner yet?
Sherry Schreiner.
Yeah.
That last name sounds suspicious.
She's here in Ohio. She's huge too.
Schreiner.
Hit up
That can't be.
Just
her
whenever
name.
You get time, you know, hit up
Sherry Schreiner.
Just hit up her name, Sherry Schreiner. She got one of the largest websites, man. That all kind of bullshit on it, but she hates Apostle Paul with all her heart.
Oh, they always hate Paul.
Everybody hated Paul, man. But
I'm surprised we ain't got
passion with her.
I'm surprised there ain't a more Israelite groups hating on Paul.
Right.
Because Paul's writings throw a whole monkey wrench into their fucking beliefs.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Especially their women beliefs.
And about the women, mm-hmm. and then about the Israelites being scattered.
Being faggots.
Oh, yeah, about faggots. Oh, yeah. Because he specifically mentions faggots.
Yep.
Yeah, because faggots don't like Paul. Women definitely hate Paul.
I finally saw them flags on Broad Street, man, but I came from out east way, though.
Oh, the faggot?
And they had the big one with God is speaking to us on it.
Oh, my.
The big one, the big fag flag. Yeah, with God. It's a big flag, too. God is speaking to us on it.
The gay pride.
They don't realize how much truth there is in that, what they say in that, though.
Yeah.
God is speaking to us.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
But, well, their parade got rained out one day.
Yeah, they trying to get their money back. They lost, like, $150,000.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Something like that.
Oh, it rained on that day?
It was a storm.
The whole weekend down there, man, I guess.
So they had to cancel that shit out.
It was flooded down there.
That was working out there.
I was like, hell.
That's crazy,
not
man.
Not today.
Yeah, right.
Not today. That cursed it. Every day I would go by it.
Cursed them.
That's what's up.
That's beautiful, man.
Flooded them out.
Yeah.
Good.
Tore their shit up. They had to panic. They had to flee out of there quick, man.
Damn,
you know, nobody made money. The merchandise, the food, nobody made money, man. Because they was estimated to make about close to $1 million from the sales and that stuff.
Damn.
And now they in the hole.
Yeah, good for them.
They in the hole.
They like holes.
You know? Hey, you see on Alex Jones. Alex Jones posted on his thing, man. Fags coming against fags. Fags carrying guns. And the other fags had a flag for red, and they tried to merge with them. And the fags that, you know, without the guns, they... Like, nah, y'all can't come in here.
Like, you ain't part of us.
Yep. And the fags. And they all, both sides sound just like Alex Jones talking the same shit with them arguing back and forth with each other. Satan's straight up divided, man. His kingdom is divided.
Well, that's why they making a big deal. Oh, they making a big deal about that Confederate flag shit, though.
Yeah, right. Like, the American flag is supposed to be accepted still, but the fuck the Confederate flag. These dumbass
and that's the funny thing, too, though, that's not even the real Confederate flag.
Right.
That's the battle flag.
It don't look like the old one. It don't look nothing
and
like
we
the
came
old
out here with a, because the real Confederate flag has three bars with a circle of stars, right?
Yep.
What's that?
Someone posted a picture of a Steelers flag. It says, "This flag offends me. Take it down."
Well, right.
That's funny.
That's the funny thing. If we came out here with an actual Confederate flag and asked people, if I had a printer,
they
I would do
know
it.
What it was. They wouldn't.
They
know
would
it.
Say it was France or Argentina.
They
wouldn't know. They wouldn't know that was Confederate. But the funny thing is, nobody has a problem with all those rainbow flags flying. When we came down High Street, every building nearly. Or every other building got a big ass rainbow flag flying.
Some of them got like five or six.
So, man, the hypocrisy of this nation is disgusting.
Hypocrisy, yeah.
They embrace faggots, you know what I'm saying? And that's supposed to be something that's supposed to be looked down upon. Being a faggot? Are you serious?
You know what proves it? They prove it themselves a fact, though. Because, you know, when you confront them with it, they hide. You know, or they run off. Cause some, you know, they know in their conscience the shit ain't right, man.
And then they'll get mad if we say the word faggot. But faggots call each other faggots too.
Call each other faggots.
They're like, oh, you a dirty little faggot. I seen why I work with them.
They like dirty little faggots, and they saying that as a compliment.
Paul, no, he's been in the restaurant business for years working with faggots. They're the nastiest people on earth.
Nasty as fuck.
They just talk nasty all day.
Someone called this flamer a faggot. He was like, you better go read a book. That ain't gonna hurt my feelings.
I heard that. Damn. You know, he keeping it real. He going out, he going hard with it. He came with his logic. His wisdom.
Man, faggot wisdom.
Ain't gonna read a book. That's funny as fuck. That means we, man, this shit is like this, man. We got, this is more, we got more work to do, man.
Yeah, a lot of work.
If it's just a small little group, man, and either they accepted it, man, or...
But there's a lot more faggots than us.
Yeah.
They got, we're outnumbered.
Yeah, yeah.
So we know it's not a numbers game.
Yeah, it's like we're 300 and they're, the Persian Empire.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, yeah, right. We're like, yeah, right. This, you is know, the Battle of Thermopylae out here.
Right.
Yeah, that's a good analogy. 300 against the Persians.
You know, that's a tiny number.
It really, that's a, yeah. Right, that was the elite. Because they had a bunch of, and that's a good metaphor. Because the 300 did have a couple thousand Arcadians helping them. Mm-hmm. But they were pretty much worthless.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And they was afraid to fight when, you know,
they wind up bailing on them.
Yeah, they bailed on one. Yeah, yeah. But it was at 300 right there. That's a very small number. That tells you, that's an actual battle that actually happened in real life. The 300 Spartans actually fought off the Persians like that. So that tells you this is not a numbers game. It's all about quality, not quantity.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
Most high is actually just saying, I don't need the numbers. Let me see if I can find
it. Oh, yeah. That's one for that. Is that Judith 9 and 11, 1 Samuel, when they talking about David? I'll get one. Judith 9 and 11. For thy power standeth not in multitude, nor thy might in strong men. Wow. For thou, we used to read this all the time.
Did we?
Yeah. For thy power standeth not in multitude, nor thy might in strong men. For thou art the God of the afflicted, a helper of the oppressed, upholder of the weak, a protector of the forlorn, a savior of them that are without hope.
Mm.
I'll keep, that's the point.
Hey, let me mark that.
Judith 9 and 11. 911. That's how I remember it.
Yeah, that's kind of similar to the story with,
David and Goliath.
And, what's her,
because of the Chinese parade.
Yeah,
it was her and her handmaid went down there.
Look at this giant group of gooks.
And chopped them's head, the general's head off. Chopped his head off. That was it. He knew it was a grisly scene.
Oh,
he
yeah.
had to chop it twice.
She must have had a sharp knife too, boy.
Yeah.
Man. That's
a... She acted the first time and it didn't get off. So yeah, it definitely got about numbers at all.
So yeah, like I said, like we used to say about women, it's all about quality, not quantity. You know what I'm saying?
Quality.
And like that one scripture said, one will chase thousands.
Oh yeah, to chase like
songs?
That's in Deuteronomy. When it says one, or you know about how we'll have the power, we should be able to chase down the heat.
This one is Psalms too.
Oh yeah, I think that probably quotes Deuteronomy, I believe.
Mm-hmm, probably.
There you go, Chen, all the way down there.
I know, I've been saw her in the first grade. I'm just claiming that
about it. He said it waited. He got that evil eye.
Yeah. Here we go, bro. Let me read this. This is Judges 7, and I'm going to start at 1. Then Jerubbaal, who is Gideon, and all the people that were with him rose up early and pitched beside the well of Harod, so that the host of the Midianites were on the north side of them by the hill of Merom in the valley. And the Lord said unto Gideon, the people that are with thee are too many for me to give the Midianites into their hands, lest Israel vaunt themselves against me, saying, my own hand hath saved me. Now, therefore, go to proclaim in the ears of the people, saying, whosoever is fearful and afraid, let him return and depart early from Mount Gilead. And there returned unto the people 22,000, and there remained 10,000. And the Lord said unto Gideon, the people are yet too many.
Oh, yeah.
Bring them down unto the water, and I will try them there for thee there, and I shall be that of whom I say unto thee, this shall go with thee, the same shall go with thee, and of whomsoever I say unto thee, this shall not go with thee, the same shall not go. So he brought down the people into the water, and the Lord said unto Gideon, everyone that lappeth of the water with his tongue as a dog lappeth, him shall thou set by himself. Likewise, everyone that bowed down to his knees to drink, and the number of them that lapped, putting their hand to their mouth, were 300 men. But all the rest of the people bowed down unto their knees to drink water. And the Lord said unto Gideon, by the 300 men that I lapped, will I save you.
At 300.
From what? What was it? Where did it start at? It started a big number at first. Twenty-two thousand down to 300. You know what I'm saying?
Big gap.
I mean, the Most High could have did it that way if he wanted.
Yeah.
But like we always say, you know, like your brother said, 300. He don't deal in mass numbers. The Lord has an ego anyway. You know, he's supposed to. You know, he would use a few numbers. I mean, it looks better. It looks more impressive.
That's what I'm saying.
One motherfucker slaughtering thousands and thousands, man. It just looks more impressive.
Just like when King David went and killed all them Canaanites and he was circumcised. Mm-hmm. Took their foreskins.
Right.
Woo! Now, don't let no Egyptologists hear that one.
You had turned that shit out. Whoa. They had turned that out, man.
I missed that scripture.
Oh, you didn't know about that?
No, I missed that scripture.
Yeah, yeah.
What? That, it wasn't his fault, though. It was Saul being wicked, making him do it. If Saul, it's Saul that made him do it, right?
Right,
because
right.
Saul was trying to get him killed. So he was trying to give him some kind of feat that would not be just... He was wanting David to die. It's not something David wanted to do.
I was like, damn, David was a straight killer.
Yeah, he was a straight killer.
He let him go. Yeah, he let him go. The Lord said, well, Saul's outside. What you want to do? You're pretty much like.
Right.
It's
bad, man.
And I always read that scripture, too. It's like, he's like, I just told him I'm going to deliver it to your hand.
I got a precept. Matthew 22 and 14. For many are called, but few are chosen. Many are called, but few are chosen. So there goes that few again. I got another precept. This, I quoted this earlier. I wanted to read it. Luke 10 and 2. Therefore said he unto them, the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest, that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. So there goes that few again. You know what I'm saying? There ain't that many laborers out here. You know what I'm saying? There's not many people even deemed worthy for combat. Just like going back to the Spartans and the 300, use that for an analogy or an allegory. They was trained for that battle. You know what I mean? Them Arcadians didn't have that training.
No, they sure. No, they didn't.
You know what I'm saying? So you got other people out that don't have no business teaching because they haven't been trained properly. You know what I'm saying? Or they haven't been training. They have put forth no effort to train, to be trained. They're not studying. They're not going deep. You know what I'm saying? Because you got a lot of people that teach the Bible. They're not deep, man. They don't get down and dirty. They memorize a few scriptures and that's it.
Romans 11.
Hey, yo, my bad. Did y'all see Nate's crew down at South Carolina? Deep.
Doing what?
Praying outside the church.
Praying
outside the church.
You know,
literally praying, and they was like, I mean, I ain't know they had that many, man. They was deep.
They just wanted the spotlight, bro.
Yeah, RT caught it.
All they want is a spotlight.
RT car. Yeah, that's all.
They just trying to get some shine.
That's all. That's all. And some money.
They're just using that. You're right. Get money.
Mm-hmm.
They just taking advantage of the situation. They're like doing like a Rahm Emanuel. They're not letting a crisis go to waste.
That's right. That's right.
You know what I mean?
That's right. That's just like
They don't give a damn about those people that got shot.
Like Angelina Jolie. Which ones went to Haiti after the earthquake and all them?
That was Brad Pitt and Angelina.
Yeah, yeah. They big with that.
George Bush and Bill Clinton.
Yeah, they're big with that, man. Whenever the disaster, you're going to see
so they can be seen.
Nicole Kidman, too.
Al Sharpton.
She was down there.
Nicole Kidman, she was big. She's big with it, too. Yep, yep. Disasters.
Hey, let's get that scripture for Nate. They like to be praying in the streets.
Oh, yeah. Matthew's on.
So, man, these people are a joke.
They know that they're in scripture, too.
No, they don't. Obviously, they don't.
No, they don't.
You would think they know it.
Right.
They don't know it.
They don't know it either.
Because you know, the Most High put a block on your mind and won't allow you to see stuff in this book. You can open it. You can try to read it.
True.
Some people I hear them say they start reading and they say they'll start getting tired and they'll get sleepy.
Right. Matthew 6 and 5. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are.
Nate, Nathaniel, Israel united in Christ. We can't.
Yeah, that's a long list.
People are a joke. You're a joke.
Yep.
Your whole congregation, you're a joke.
Yep. For they are. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you that they have their reward.
So yeah, Nathaniel and all the IUIC, you got your reward. Your reward is missiles, hellfire. That's your reward, is the missiles.
Wait till the Lord open the can. Look at the can at him. The can, man.
They could be next.
Yep.
You
yep.
want to be seen so bad, maybe the government took notice of you. You know
that's
what I mean?
That's right.
Oh, they're already in with the government. So it'd be easy to do a hit on them.
Hell yeah.
So Nate could call up some of his government partners and y'all could get shot up next. It's by an MK Ultra mind control agent.
What's that one thing churches have? You know, to pay taxes.
501c3.
Yeah, Nate got that.
He's 501c3. He's a cop. He's a detective.
Peraza has to have it too in order for him to be having that house, man. That wicked ass house he has.
I
ain't doubting it, man. Because when I confirmed them with it before, they didn't say shit.
Oh, yeah.
They didn't deny it. Especially when I ran into his. Remember we was at the gambling spot. Dude ignored it.
Oh, you see him at Hollywood.
Yeah. Me and Paul did.
And he wasn't even about no truth.
Oh,
he man, probably didn't want to be seen talking to you.
What did he say? Sabbath or some shit.
I wasn't like listening to him.
Yeah. No, he was a weird, wasn't he?
And he is a weirdo.
Yeah, weird.
And he was packing a pistol too, wasn't he?
A weirdo.
I seen him with a pistol.
Because they're cops. They work at lawyer spots. I mean, they downtown,
something
man.
Ain't right about them dudes.
You know, they downtown, man. They all these motherfuckers are strapped too. Shit. All these college motherfuckers, man.
Is that you?
No, someone just threw a rock at us.
Wow, that was a pathetic throw. I gotta turn around.
That's funny, man. That's fucking funny, man. And look where it is.
Get that little itty bitty rock
right
there.
That force field is right here. That force field.
Somebody had a rock in their car.
I heard it hit. Yeah. I heard it hit.
I looked over, it was like.
I heard it.
They got Tribauer back up next time a couple pieces.
Oh, you got
no, it. Could have, like, see, bounced off. They could have ran over it with their tire and it
you
flew
know,
up here.
You know, I'm just joking.
There's
another one right there.
Yeah, it could have happened.
Damn. Yeah, I've seen that, too.
Because when a rock in the car,
said,
when a tire a flicks a rock,
that's
man.
That's what I'm saying, man.
When a car, that rubber flicks a rock, because I see it happen a lot, it shoots like a bullet.
Oh,
yeah, it does.
Maybe that's what it was. I don't know.
I was in the truck the other day and a little pebble cracked the
windshield.
Little tiny pebble.
Damn.
It was like a few years ago, and I think I ain't never said nothing about it, but you know, like a little branch that would normally just roll off a fallout tree and roll off the window.
Yeah.
I noticed three different cities, and this was like 3-4 years ago, that branches fell out the windows and killed motherfuckers through their cars.
Oh, yeah.
I was just saying to myself, man, the Most High is just kept
that, that's precision hit.
Hell yeah, little branches that, and they show one of them, I remember actually, they showed a couple of them, the branch still in the middle, that looked like, man, it's impossible.
Right.
It's fucking impossible, man. we about to see some weird shit happen, man, that we can only explain by the Lord that the Lord did.
It's been raining too. Those fires and shit, man. That goddamn tornado fire went over the freeway.
Yeah.
There's no way they was mind boggled. Like, how the hell?
8-lane freeway?
Yeah. How the hell get over the freeway?
8-lane freeway.
You ain't seeing raining fish in Sweden and raining fish in China?
Oh, no. I thought you was clowning.
No, it was raining fish.
Wow.
It's in the news today or yesterday. Get on Drudge. It's raining fish.
I saw the one where the spiders just came up.
Yeah, that was that too.
You see that one?
Well, they do that. They throw their webs up. That can be explained.
Oh, yeah.
When the spiders migrate, they glide.
That web is the piercing.
Yeah.
It's their way of travel.
There were some motherfucking spiders over, I forgot what country, but
waterspout.
They ain't know where the fucking spiders came from. They came through. They don't know what kind of species spiders these are or nothing. They came through, fucked everybody up, and left.
Wow.
You can look that up.
That'd be gruesome.
Spider invasion, this type of spider invasion.
Right.
It was over there in one of them countries.
That's some freaky shit.
Florida is being invaded right now by Asian wasps.
Damn.
The normal wasps are like this big.
Oh, you talking about the Japanese wasps?
They're like this big.
Yeah,
They're like that big, and they kill people.
Yeah.
They're killing, like, every day someone died over there.
Thousands die from them shit every year.
Yep. And they're in Florida now. They're in Florida.
There's an acid in their venom or something like that. They sting you.
Yep.
It eats your flesh.
Yep. Because a grown man got stung by 9 of them, and he was unrecognizable, and he dropped
dead. You know the bugs are spiritual, because usually the bugs they never attack me. I ain't gonna say never, most likely jack me up.
Right.
But I be chilling with bees, just looking at them, let a bee land on me.
Mm-hmm. I got a big ass tree in my backyard the flowers blossom on it, and it's hundreds of big old fat bumblebees, regular bees, but bumblebees.
I love them.
I be up close looking at them.
Yeah, they're amazing.
Yep, they're beautiful, man.
They are.
It's a bad creation, man. It's a bad creation.
And they won't mess with you unless you're evil.
Yep.
Start doing some evil.
There's some heathen nations.
Yeah.
Some heathen nations. Just like the shark attacks that's been happening the last few weeks.
Yeah.
That's all Edomites. All Edomites are getting eat up.
You ever watch
let me get the image.
I was just watching some shit on the heathens last. Well, I was watching Matthew Santoro. You ever watch Matthew Santoro on YouTube?
Man,
it's a popular amongst little kid. My sons be watching. But it's like, this dude, all he does is just teach, bring out interesting facts, conspiracy theories. But this dude on YouTube, his name is Matthew Santoro. He's popular as hell. My sons watch him, and I was watching. But he was talking about how in all these Asian countries and over there in Asia, all kinds of people that get all kinds of crazy diseases related to them eating lizards and snakes. They get parasites in their eyes, like little lizards. Lizards. They get like little tiny worms and snakes go in their eyes,
right in their pupils. Like
and they get it because they eat lizards and they eat snakes and all these unclean animals.
Unlawful shit.
So that's why you ever wonder why all these weird diseases come out of China and Asia, Thailand and Saudi Arabia. That's because they're heathens.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not following the law. They're not eating clean.
They had one of the major countries where they had fucking like worms coming out of his face.
Yeah, I seen that. They got parasites to make your face swell up this big.
Yeah.
Woo.
That shit was fucking hideous. Looked like little maggots. And they were scraping it off his face. And every time they scraped it white, so more would just be that shit was like, God damn.
And then they got the other dudes that he got this condition that turns the skin into bark.
Yeah, tree man.
Oh, I seen that. Yeah.
He looked just like a tree too.
Ain't that something? Yeah. Will plague the shit out of you, man. They be looking like a creature from a comic book.
Looking like Swamp Thing and shit.
Yeah, for real.
Sure fuck would. This is Ecclesiastes 39 and 28:27. All these things are for good to the godly. So to sinners, they are turned into evil. There be spirits, they are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sour strokes. In the time of destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them. Fire and hail and famine and death, all these were created for vengeance. teeth of wild beasts and scorpions, serpents, and the sword, punishing the wicked to destruction.
Yeah, so Most High put the spirit on a the Most High put the spirit on the wild beast.
Look at your homie over there.
Oh, this dude's nuts. He looked like he just did him on camera.
Oh, wow.
Now, don't be scared. Just put his ass on camera. Wow. If they don't like it, they don't need to walk down the street.
Take that shit off, dude. No, why can't you take that shit off?
Yeah.
he's on camera right now. We ain't got to put it on camera.
I mean, that's what happens when you be a weirdo. We got to document it.
All these cameras up and down the street.
That's what he's trying to pull in the morning.
He's actually probably, he's wearing a garment made of all the same material. He thinks he's following the law.
What's that scripture where the Most High totally fucked up? This one king had his skin melting off of him. He was so funky.
Maccabees. Yeah, that's Maccabees.
He started stinking.
Yeah.
His guards and shit was like, oh.
He gave one of those plagues like those damn heathens.
Here you go.
That's like Reek from Game of Thrones.
His own men, they didn't want him to carry him because his stench was so bad.
Hello, everybody.
How you doing?
His men was like wasn't even trying to carry him because he stunk so goddamn bad.
Yeah, that's some funny shit, man. We used to bring that.
I was reading that scripture was cracking up. I was like, that's what your ass get.
Yeah, I like reading.
Being so goddamn proud. Yeah, it's
unfortunate. Yeah,
his
freaking
skin start melting. Like, come on, what kind of plague is that?
Can you imagine that?
Your skin melt off.
It's not melting. It's like rotting off.
Yeah,
because it stinks.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So you can just hear it plop on the ground like.
Mm-hmm. Let me see if I can find sound.
It, man. Yeah. I forget. It's the second Maccabees,
eh? Yeah, it's the second Maccabees.
That's crazy, because every time I read scriptures, I can, like, picture myself, like, there. And as soon as I read that part, when it was saying how his flesh was just oozing off
doesn't
the skin,
say stink?
You could just, I was just hearing stink. The sounds hitting the ground.
It might say stink. Like,
second Maccabees 9.
Yeah, 9 and 10.
Man. That's what I'm saying, man.
Second Maccabees 9 and 10. You just read that one. That's a...
Second Maccabees. It may got highlighted.
It says his intolerable stink.
Oh, that's what I'm going to start at 1, man. Yeah. You see, look, I got marked. Got me marked. Ha!
Yeah, ha! Well, Second Maccabees what?
9.
No.
I should have highlighted that, man. Because I was dying when I was reading this. I was cracking. I was like, that's what his ass get.
Man, but people don't even know about Maccabees.
Yeah, it's crazy shit.
Hell yeah.
Crazy. We were bad though, man. We saw a lot of we witnessed the angels doing a lot of miracles there.
Yeah, the angels came out of the sky.
Mm-hmm. A lot of bad shit, man. A lot of stuff. Okay, here we go. Second Maccabees 9:1. Now, at that time, Antiochus was dishonored out of the country of Persia, for he had entered the city called Persepolis.
Persepolis, that's in Persia.
Yeah. And went about to rob the temple.
Yeah, that's where ISIS was over there trying to destroy the ancient ruins of that city.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Actually, they're getting business to it.
Yeah, they didn't fucking.
And to hold the city, whereupon the multitude running to defend themselves with their weapons put them to flight. And so it happened that Antiochus being put to flight. Of the inhabitants returned with shame. Now, when he came to Ecbatan, news was brought him what happened unto Nicanor and Timotheus. Then, swelling with anger, he thought to avenge upon the Jews the disgrace done unto him by those that made him flee. Therefore, commanded he his chariot man to drive without ceasing and to dispatch the journey. The judgment of the Most High now following him, for he had that angel. Can you imagine that? You don't say the angel. It says, therefore commanded his chariot man to drive without ceasing and to dispatch to journey. The judgment of the Most High now following him, for he had spoken proudly in this sort. Now, the scripture in Ecclesiastes, I think it's Ecclesiastes when it says, don't curse the king, not in thy bed chambers or something, or a bird, or something that with wings shall go tell the matter, something like that.
Yeah.
You know, this motherfucker was talking shit about, just talking shit. The judgment of the Most High now following him, for he has spoken proudly in this sort, that he would come to Jerusalem and make it a common burying place of the Jews. This nigga was on a mission.
Yeah, he was on a mission. He wanted to make the land a cemetery.
Ooh, yeah, right, a giant cemetery with nothing but Israelites allowed to be buried in that motherfucker. But the Lord Almighty, the power of Israel, smote him with an incurable and invisible plague.
An invisible plague. Mm.
For as soon as he had spoken these words, a pain of the bowels that was remnantless came upon him. Now, you had diarrhea before.
Right. And you can't, worse.
And you ain't got no choice but to go sit your ass down.
Yep.
Can you imagine? For an incurable and invisible plague, for as soon as he had spoken these words, a pain of the bowels that was remnantless came upon him.
They said a pain in the bowels.
And sour torment of the inner parts. Man, that's the most torturous, having diarrhea and that, and the stomach virus.
Yeah, all that in one.
Woo! And the Most High added more.
That is flesh milk.
And that most justly, for he had tormented other men about in plain torment. So he did the same shit to people. Yep. Poisoning them and giving them shit, laughing and shit. Having a good time.
That's how they do it too, they like to poison people.
Yeah, clowning. I know people like that too. Howbeit, he nothing at all ceased from his bragging. He thought the shit was
bad. It's kind of off topic, but it's on time. I was listening to Roddy Piper and I've been listening to wrestling radio sometimes. You know, I like wrestling, you know what I mean? Everyone, I'll be checking out, but they was talking about that wrestler, the British Bulldog.
Yeah.
That he died. But they say he was a dick. They say he used to beat people up in the locker room. But they said he was real mean. They said he took this special needs kid, this retarded kid, he was handicapped. And shot his ass up with steroids.
Oh, man. Damn.
Like you said, you know people that shoot people up with shit?
Well, they do drug and put shit people's drinks.
Yeah. They say he was drugging other dudes with halcyons.
Well, he got his drug.
Yeah, because a lot of dudes will do that. That's that date rape pill, the halcyon. And drop, you know, you drug a bitch, you go fuck her, she'll never know I hit her.
Yeah.
But you got dudes that do that to other dudes, too.
Yeah.
Ass raping.
And that's who that motherfucker I knew was doing. They was doing it to this dude.
I heard it was big in that motorcycle shit.
Probably.
That's what I told you. The dude I'm talking about was in the motorcycle shit.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Remember, he's a terror, though.
Told
he's
me
a terror.
That told me that.
I saw this motherfucker in Myers, man. I seen him, he turned right there. He saw him turn right there. You know what I'm saying? Walking just like, everybody think he's black, man, but he's an Edomite. Walk just like an Edomite.
Yeah.
You know?
Gay and shit.
Yeah.
You showed me that drug dude. You showed me a picture of him too.
Oh, I got it on my phone. Yeah. It's here.
I say, yeah, you got cruel people in the world who like to
cruel.
Yeah, just do cruel shit to people.
Yeah. But the same judgment's coming back to visit them. And that the most justly, for he had tormented other men's bowels with many and strange torments. Strange.
What the hell is he doing?
You know.
They say other men's bowels?
Yeah.
So it was
how do you do
other
shit.
Men's bowels?
What the fuck?
What the fuck? Right. What the fuck?
Hey, but that's Esau, though. You dude's a Macedonian. That's the Bible tells you the Macedonians and the Alexander's people were Edomites. So they like to. They're obsessed with the asshole.
Shit.
They have it with doo-doo and scat sex.
Yep.
And bowel movements. They have an obsession with that.
Mm-hmm.
That's why there's so many faggot flags everywhere.
Yep.
That's why it's cool to be a faggot.
You know, all these nasty porn sites, everybody's eating ass.
Yeah, everybody eating ass.
Everybody's eating ass, man.
Scatted.
SMA.
They have whole scat parties.
Woo!
Right.
Woo!
A whole goddamn party.
Scat party. I wonder, you can imagine the smell of that.
Yeah, walking that goddamn.
But the smell of shit that Esau, though, is like.
He immune to it and shit.
Well, he likes it. That probably turns him on.
Yeah, Esau was probably rubbing animal shit on him when he's going through the woods, the fitting. Oh, yeah. You know, that's part of being camouflaged.
Yeah, they do that.
They can actually rub shit on him.
Yeah. Get rid of that human smell.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Well, you be watching them TV shows where Esau get raised by a pack of wolves. Unless you think that dude's a Jake. I ain't never seen.
Yeah, I gotta check that out.
You seen that?
Yeah, I know. I know.
Cause you think
about.
The wolves would eat Esau though?
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
Yeah, but I mean,
you never know.
Unless he's fucking the shit out of him, the animals grow fond of him. They grow fond of him. You know what I'm saying? That's true. That does happen.
Yeah,
it does happen. You know?
Yeah. Oh yeah, Esau got pet dogs too.
That's right. You saw? Remember that bitch had a face hanging off by the monkey?
Yeah,
yeah.
They was fucking that monkey. Yeah, her and the girl.
She was raping him.
Yep. Oh, and turned against him. Yeah, it's real. Ate her face off.
That was, I know all that.
You like, know this bitch tried to sue the city for that and lost.
People always trying to sue somebody for shit they did.
For any reason to get paid, man.
Hate her fucking face. I remember that too.
You should see it to this day, man.
That shit is funny.
Yeah. Fucking ape, man. It was a chimpanzee. Fucking chimpanzee. I was at the zoo one time, and a motherfucking monkey is giving another one a blowjob, and ain't nobody eating my standing there like in awe.
And taking pictures and
shit. Yeah, and yeah, like being in my line, everybody was like, I don't want to see that shit.
Yeah, I done seen that shit on YouTube. Just kept going, and man.
And they standing there like they ready to jack off and shit, man.
Yeah.
They were standing there like they watching a real porno.
I done seen that shit on YouTube.
They probably busted out their phones.
They did have their shit. I was recording. Yeah, man. It was like a bunch of them. Remember Edomites?
Yep. I didn't see some shit like that.
Nasty, foul ass people, man.
Foul as fuck, man.
Just foul, man. These some backwards ass people, man. They lock animals up. Say, they tell the world we love these animals and that we care for them with all our hearts. What the fuck? You got them locked the fuck up.
Got them locked up. Fucking them in the ass. Like, either the border, yeah, the border going with you.
Man, the border.
Look at them.
We
white
borders of blue.
Look how they raise the farm animals.
You know what I'm
saying? They raise chickens in cages. And they chop their beaks off. That's
That's sad, man. That's a sad thing. That's a sad sight, man. You watch them videos, man. Them chicken houses or whatever you call them.
Yeah,
man.
That's,
they
that's
tiny ass. Yeah, that's fucked up, man. Even what they do to the pigs, man.
And I was listening to research, and this guy said the animals that was raised in better conditions tasted better.
Yeah,
Esau's ass. I was doing some research on that one machine they got over in, I think, in Switzerland. It's like a big, gigantic mechanical
CERN
board.
Talking about CERN?
Yeah.
Talking about the particle collider?
Yeah.
They're about to fire it up again.
September
24th. The blood moon is us. That is the big theory on the internet right now.
Yeah.
This is the new doomsday prediction everybody made. Not me.
2012 gone.
Yeah, since 2012 is gone, now the new date.
New
well, the blood moon is on September 28th. But so on September 24th, they're going to fire up the particle collider at CERN. And it's gonna open up a trans-dimensional vortex, and the demons are gonna come out the vortex and be unleashed on the earth.
All the scientists is coming out saying, Stephen Hawking's coming out saying, that one popular black scientist, they all saying it's gonna open some crazy shit, man. And I was just reading this yesterday.
You never know, but
I was just reading it yesterday. Nah, Esau ain't got that much power. He got some shit that's probably gonna be. It's probably gonna cause an explosion.
I thought the portal was already open.
Right. It's already open.
Vegas out here.
Yeah.
All type of abominable thing.
I remember little Nicky when his brothers escaped from hell and went to Earth.
Yeah, whatever they doing that CERN, they're mingling shit where they shouldn't have.
It's like that out here right now.
Oh, it is what it is.
It's kind of weird how everything is coming into place. It's starting to play out now, man. Because that shit with Obama, the Senate, Congress signed, and they just...
TPP.
TPP.
We got Republicans backing
it. That's huge, man.
You got Democrats opposed him.
Yeah, but they're right on the bandwagon.
Yeah, but I thought Republicans were against Obama.
You thought?
Right. I thought too. I mean, I already knew better.
Right.
Obviously.
Right. You know, they're all on the same page.
We'd be sarcastic so
that's
much.
That's huge, man. Because it's locking shit up now, man.
Yeah.
That leads the way to them rationing medical supplies,
censoring
food, the internet control. That's just so huge, you can't explain it all.
Right.
It's just huge, man.
That's why it's trans-Pacific.
Hey, Alex Jones had tears in his eyes, damn, it looked like that shit bad.
It is all over. I don't think we can turn it around.
Yeah, right. You can't
I forgot about these pictures of the little Nicky. right here.
Oh, the Twin Towers.
Yeah, you got the Twin Towers in the background, and he's the Satan spawn right there. No, look.
There's
but,
two posters.
And then when he turns into the angel, look, the Twin Towers are gone. Oh, all the other buildings are still there.
Right, right. Look at see the mushroom cloud, the nuke.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because that came out before 9/11, didn't it?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know.
That's the picture. Wink.
I never seen the movie.
The little nickel.
Oh yeah, little Nicky. I remember that movie.
Oh, that's the second picture. That's the first picture. See how all the buildings are in the background?
Yeah.
They got the Twin Towers
you
back there.
You can't get that on camera, can you?
I'll try.
That's bad. I can. You can put
the same building back there, but the Twin Towers are gone.
Eddie George's.
Interesting.
Yeah. That was before 9/11.
Yeah, because I remember that came out in the late 90s, little Nicky.
Get out of here.
That came out in the late 90s.
Look, yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah, 97, 98.
Was it? I thought it was a little later.
98, 99, we got the latest. Yeah. I remember that, heard that goofy ass movie.
Because there's all kind of satanic symbolism in that. Well, it's about the devil.
It's too blurry.
Yeah, you ain't gonna
I'll
be
able to download it when I get home.
Hey, let's get back to that scripture. Finish that before this battery.
You know what, hold this?
Before that. Yeah, before, camera goes out.
We back to foul ass Esau. Okay, howbeit he nothing, and that most justly he had tormented other men's bowels with many and strange torments.
I can't get over that.
Right, right. That takes deep study, don't it?
Just sticking all type of shit up their ass. Yeah. It's fucking weird.
It's right, right.
You like Caligula. You watch Caligula, and he fisted dude.
God, during his wedding.
During his wedding, he fisted his dude.
And his wife.
I mean, he had a big ring on it. Stuck his, fisted his dude right in the ass.
He looked at it like, ugh.
That probably goddamn Tom his ancestors, descendants probably.
Yeah, you're right. How be it, he nothing at all ceased from his bragging, but still was filled with pride, breathing out fire in his rage against the Jews and commanding to haste the journey. But it came to pass that he fell down from his chariot, carried violently, so that having a sour fall, all the members of his body were much pained. And thus he that a little afore thought he might command the ways of the sea, so proud was he beyond the condition of man, and weight the height mountains in his balance. That brings to mind Obama, how proud he is.
Yeah, very proud.
Well, he's so proud, like when that shooting happened down in South Carolina, but just a couple of hours later, he's using it to talk about how he's going to take everybody's guns.
Yeah.
Like nobody sees what you're doing.
Straight up. False flag.
Yeah.
Set up.
Like nobody's. And everybody sees it. He's so proud, he don't even care if you can see it.
Don't even care, right, right. Well, nobody in the hood see it.
Well, no, but but a lot of people are awake to that.
Right, right,
to
right.
The false flag.
Right, right.
They might not be awake to the truth in the scriptures, but they are to the false flags and
well, that's because of us.
Yeah, right.
You know, that's because of us.
Because they want to take.
They want to see what they want to see.
They don't want to eat the whole roll.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Exactly. Let me blow my nose.
They didn't want to finish their supper. They just want to eat a little bit of
meat. Eat the vegetables.
They ate all the vegetables. They eat no meat.
Nah, the kids don't like vegetables.
Oh, you remember that Pink Floyd song? you can't have any dessert unless you eat your meat.
Right, right.
Now, what does it say? You can't have any pudding unless you eat your meat?
That's right.
You remember that Pink Floyd? They had truth in that Pink Floyd song. When they was like, we don't need no education. We don't need no false control. And it's like, teacher, leave them kids alone.
That's actually a bad answer.
Yeah. I mean, it's real popular, but there's truth in that. He was telling you the school system is some bullshit. And yeah, that bass line is dope, man.
And thus, he that a little before thought he had might command the ways of the sea, so proud was he beyond the conditions of man, and weighed the high mountains in a balance, was now cast on the ground and carried in horse litter, showing forth unto all the manifest power of the Most High, so that the worms rose up out of the body of this wicked man.
Worms, he had worms coming up out of his body. That's nasty. That's just like the maggots. It's like you have maggots coming out of the swine's flesh.
Yeah,
they didn't say maggots, worms.
Worms. What the fuck?
Worms.
And we know that's possible, like we was talking earlier, how people get the worms in their eyes, and they got the parasites, tapeworm. Most I got some crazy ass parasites for your ass.
I saw enough documentaries for shit. Yeah. I already know.
Yeah. Hey, I mean, them documentaries will give you nightmares.
They show you that.
You got parasites that probably still laying dormant for hundreds of years.
Yep.
Imagine people just eat pork though, man. There's fat and obese. They don't have normal bowel movements. Imagine what's in them. Just imagine what's in them, man. Yeah,
18 parasites in a pork that can't be even killed.
Yeah, right.
Let alone digest.
Yeah.
And then when you eat the pork, you can't digest it. It sits in your intestines for a month.
Their worm has a permanent home.
Yep. Then they got parasites that just go up inside your brain.
Oh, my Lord.
And they got worms that go up in your brain.
I haven't seen that.
And slowly feeds on your brain. Yeah. You might just think, I just have a headache.
Yeah, that's what
you're saying. You end up with paralysis.
Yep.
For no reason.
Oh, a dude made some bacon at work today, and then he went and ate it with his biscuits and sausage gravy. He came back, he's like, man, I can't even work now. My brain just feels all cluttered. And
good for him.
It's that damn pork.
That's good for him.
That's what I told him.
You should have said, good for you, buddy.
You're right, you know what I'm saying? Good for you.
That's what made me stop. That's what made me stop eating pork. One day I ate a pepperoni pizza, I thought I was going to die. I was like, no more.
Yep. Had a serious migraine headache one time. Ate a motherfucking goddamn deer bacon burger.
That probably ain't even really bacon.
Let's finish this up before that camera dies.
Okay, so that the worms rose up out of the body of this wicked man, and while he lived in sorrow and pain, his flesh fell away, and the filthiness of his smell was noisome to all his army. It was just falling off in chunks.
Plop, plop, hitting the ground.
This has still got 20 minutes.
So. Oh, does it? I didn't know. You know, the cameras would be dying always at the wrong time.
Yeah, right. And the man that thought a little afore he could reach to the stars of heaven, this motherfucker just thought he was the shit. No man could endure to carry for his intolerable stink.
Read that again. It said his intolerable.
Listen. And the man that thought a little afore he could reach to the stars of heaven, no man could endure to carry for his intolerable stink.
The intolerable stink.
Smell like the black woman's pussy.
Hey, man. I
ain't wanted to deal with
that. Oh, that's some stanky shit, boy. Get on the Coda bus. But you can get around some of these funky ass armpits. You got some people, they stink so bad, they can wash their pits 20 times a day. It would still stink.
Yeah.
They just naturally stinky.
Mm-hmm. There's some hamites.
That's a curse, man.
The hamites
be just funking up the place.
Yeah,
them Arabs too. Yep. You ever go up in the little corner stores? They think that little incense they got burning can hide it.
Ain't hiding shit.
You can't hide it. That's how you know the difference between a heathen and an Israelite. An Israelite, they could be as filthy as they want to be, but they cannot produce that kind of stink that a heathen could produce. It's a special kind of stink. You know what I mean?
Hey, the time I ran up for 2 days in this crib, though, they was pretty close.
They was getting there, but it's
still
they
was trying to get there.
It wasn't
him
there
and his buddy, everybody was funky as hell. Didn't smell like no one took a bath in days, man. And everybody sitting around looking for their next high, man, you know?
Oh, I heard this story. Someone was right there when Dave robbed him.
Okay.
Robbing people?
I'll tell y'all when I turn the camera off.
I'm sure he did it in the name of the Lord.
That's Dave for you. I know he did. I know he threw it.
Well, fuck it. I'll just say it real quick. He robbed someone for $2 with his BB gun.
For $2?
Yeah, and then they called the cops on him. And the cops were already on the way, and he went back to the exact same spot and robbed another person for $60, and the cops was right there.
Wow.
Is that what he got locked up for?
Yeah.
Again?
What's y'all doing out here?
What's up?
Read the Bible, read the scripture. Okay. Prophets of the Lord.
What you got there, man?
Prophets of the Lord, man.
Yes.
What is that?
It's the Christian consciousness.
I saw somebody have this other day. There's a lot of these going around somewhere, man. There's a lot of witchcraft in there.
I don't know. There's a Christian consciousness. A lot of people think that hermetic philosophy
such devil worship, but it's not.
You say hermetic.
Yes,
this was like some Hindu stuff right here.
Why do they got the?
They got false gods.
Why you got the heathen god Shiva?
Well,
first of all, you said the heathen god Shiva, so you just acknowledge that there's another portion of that.
No, no, there's only one
god.
That's not what he meant, though.
Okay, good.
That's not what he meant.
Because
there is only one source.
Yeah, the Hindu.
And I agree on that too. But
why you got that book?
Check it out. Let me tell you. This is why.
This is the only book you need right here.
This is why. Check out. This is why. To experience comes wisdom. Knowledge,
right?
Hold on, let me finish the statement. Through wisdom, experience comes first of knowledge.
First of
knowledge,
wisdom
is power.
Let him talk for a second.
Through experience comes wisdom and knowledge. And through wisdom and knowledge comes power. So those who have had experience before us have more power. They just work with the law of the source.
What if it was the retarded people that came before? Should we listen to them because they came before us?
No, they came before us and they were tartars and they went back to the earth. They came back to the earth.
Let me read a scripture real quick.
Okay.
First Chronicles 16 and 25. For great is Yahweh and greatly to be feared. I mean, and greatly to be praised. He is also to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the people are idols.
That's the biggest lie. No. The Bible's twisted. It's part of the truth with moments of brightness. Now check it out. The Bible, the Catholic Church has lied to people.
You're right. Catholic.
Fear is not in the story at all.
This is not the Catholic.
Okay, Catholic, Christian, all that.
No, we're not the Christians. Okay. We're the Hebrew.
I know. This looks like. I know. That's why I came, guys. You guys look like John the Wiltshire. So I just wanted to say that actually, Rastafarians acknowledge the Bible has truth, but they know that it's delusional.
How is that?
Because it's been changed so many times.
What's been changed?
First of all, there's no fear at all. You're not supposed to fear anything. If you believe that well-being is a dominant force in the universe, you have nothing to fear, right?
Yeah, you fear the Lord.
But who is the Lord? Well-being, right? So well-being
no,
is a...
Lord is the spirit.
Yes, unconditional love and well-being is the Lord.
No, the Lord is everything.
Right.
He is love and hate.
And that comes with, right, that comes with unconditional love. And you shouldn't fear the Lord because... If you believe that well-being is the dominant force of the universe, and you focus on well-being, you have nothing to fear.
We don't believe that. We don't believe well-being.
We believe in balance. Okay.
Balance.
Okay. So you don't believe
that. Hate, evil.
Here you go. Proverbs 1:7. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge.
The fear. So if you don't fear the Lord, you haven't even begun your path of knowledge yet.
But fools despise wisdom and instruction.
That, you know what? That explains why everything's all out of whack right now. No one fears
I
the
know
Lord.
That I'm comfy in the no divine mind the of the all. Yes, I used to have fear, but I'm comfortable in the divine. Yes, I'm comfortable in the divine mind of the all, so there's nothing to fear.
My nigga.
Right?
My
nothing
nigga.
To fear.
And that's why the world, that's why the world's this shit how it is, because no one fears the Lord.
You can put it like that.
No one fears the Lord.
We can put it like that because they don't believe in God.
So what does the fear of the Lord mean?
Lack of understanding for God.
This is what the fear of the Lord is. It's that you're not going to steal. Why? How come you will not steal? Why? Because you know.
Expecting someone else's property.
No, because also you know it's wrong.
Right.
Why is it wrong?
Most of the time it's wrong.
But there's a fear there because you don't want to do that because you know it's wrong.
Right, your emotions are your God.
So why don't you kill people? There's a fear because you know that's wrong. And you don't want to do something wrong because you know in your spirit there's repercussions.
There's no right or wrong. You just said that there's no dominant force.
I never said that.
You said there's no dominant force.
I said the Lord creates good and evil.
But there's no dominant force. So that means there's no right. That means
no,
there's
no
right
dominant
or wrong.
Force. It's,
what's
yeah.
wrong is when your emotions tell you you're wrong, when you feel that. Like you said, when your emotions give you that crappy feeling, that's how you know you're going the wrong way.
Here you go.
But all you got to do is focus on the light.
What if your emotions tell you that to go up inside another man's asshole?
Well, you know what? Sometimes I put another man's asshole.
Yeah. What if your emotions would be a homosexual?
Sodomite.
Be a sodomite. Know? What if your emotions tell you to go blow another man? You follow your emotions,
it
right?
I mean, if that's your place, I mean, no. I mean, God is infinite thought, right? Does God have infinite thought? It's omniscient, right?
Okay.
So God thought of everything, right? So isn't that part of it? Isn't that one thing that was thought of? That we have to turn it to light, right? That's without chaos cannot defend you no growth.
Here you
right?
go. Here you go.
Without darkness, there could be no light.
Listen, you're
so
right.
Don't exactly. you need need the darkness to make for growth?
Okay.
So yes, when you have that feeling, you didn't want to build.
That don't mean you're
That's part yeah. of their growth.
Here you go. Ecclesiastes 33:14. Good is set against evil, and life against death. So is the godly against the sinner.
The
sinner against the godly.
So we have
there is
this
no
battle.
Sin.
Yes, there is.
No, there isn't. You sin when you go against your heart.
What is sin? What is the word sin?
Your
means
heart?
Sin.
So
sin
look upon all the
time.
Words of the Most
sin
High.
Sin is time.
So look upon no. all the words
sin is
of
time.
The Most High.
Once you get outside of time, you're outside of sin.
And two, one against the other.
Sin is time. Time is sin. There's no
which,
sin.
Love, what's that, John?
Unconditional love. How can it be sin if it's unconditional
which
love?
Remember?
If God loves everything, how can it be sin?
I'm about to tell
doesn't
you
make sense.
That scripture
that doesn't I'm make sense. If God is unconditional love, how can there be sin?
We never said that.
That's right. I'm the one who says unconditional love.
That's madness.
Because we all know that the world is not full of unconditional love.
I know right now, though, that I am in a lot of agreement with you guys.
Okay.
I just want to make that clear because sometimes people think that I'm arguing when I'm not. And I'm just trying
to. You're in the wrong, are you?
Good. Well, I'm not arguing at all. I don't like to argue.
Contention.
I just wanted to come over here and share my thoughts with you guys and have you share yours with mine. You know what I'm saying?
I got a scripture.
I wouldn't read out of that Bible. At least it's what kind is it? Is it King James? Get it from the original Greek and Hebrew, man.
We do that too, bro. Yeah, we do that too.
Good. You should know that if you know that, you should know you shouldn't feel sorry for your sins.
What's a sin?
Yeah.
What's
no sin. You know what repent means?
Scrambled eggs.
What does repent really mean? To change your mind, right? Right? To change your mind. It doesn't mean
go back to
feel sorry for your sin. It means to change your mind.
Never say anything about feeling sorry. Let me read this.
Oh, yeah, but there's a lot of church.
Jeremiah 17:9. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked.
So you
can't know it.
You're spilling your heart out to
your heart.
Your heart can lie, yes.
It does.
It's important to have a person like me who is so-called expanding right now.
Hey, that's a Duke boy.
A person
shit.
Like me who is so-called expanding right now.
Yeah, that's a Duke. It looks bad.
General.
That's a popular horror too.
Sin is going to get your heart. Remember that.
1 John 3:4.
I used to hate it here.
Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law. For sin is the transgression of
sin
the law.
Is
the law, but what's the law?
The law of Moses.
The law. No, the real law, the universe. Love.
You saw what Jimmy
no, it's
bro?
The real law of the universe is love. When you go against love, man. When you go against love in your heart, that's sin.
Is this according to the scripture?
Yes, yeah, this is according to the Emerald Tablets and the Kabbalah.
Oh, the Emerald Tablets.
Oh, he said,
yes.
Oh, my.
What's wrong with
that's witchcraft.
Oh, yeah, see, everybody puts
told
it up.
You.
Oh, that's witchcraft.
I told him when he walked up, his book is full of witchcraft, man.
It's not witchcraft.
I told you, I rented
that's
somebody
what
the, with
that's
book
that's what the Illuminati wants you to think.
He was telling me everything that was in it, man.
That's what the Illuminati wants you to think.
That's what the Illuminati printed
that
shit.
No, the Catholic Church is the Catholic Church is the Antichrist. You know what I'm saying?
You're the Antichrist.
The Catholic Church is the Antichrist.
You're the Antichrist.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Every truth is a half-truth.
No,
what?
Every truth is a half-truth.
That sounds just like some Jimi Hendrix or something.
So let me ask you, what's coming? So,
because you have truths on this side, you have truths on this side, you have chaos on this side, you bring them together, you can have truths.
Can I ask you a question?
Did Madonna teach you any of that shit?
Can I ask you a serious question,
bro?
He just read the
heart. It's all serious.
I just want to get a real question.
You read Proverbs?
Have you been in contact with the Pleiadians?
Seriously.
The Greys?
No, I don't believe aliens. See, that's the Illuminati bullshit.
Oh, because, no, you don't believe aliens.
Our gods are aliens. No, they're not aliens, they're higher beings. When they say they're aliens, that's a deception. Now, some of them are. There's some aliens
out right there.
There are some aliens that come from other planets that want to dominate us. But Thoth. You don't believe there's no alien in the universe.
Oh, that's fake.
But Thoth is a higher being. Thoth is a higher being.
Yeah, it's true.
He's an entity
well,
like.
We're talking about life forms on different planets and stuff. No.
The Earth
you
is
don't
the center
that
of the
there's
universe.
Any life on any other planet out here this whole
you know what? There's
billions of galaxies.
I'll
put it
this way.
The center of the universe.
Listen, when I go this way. There's probably
animal grain of salt.
I'm sure you
can
burn.
That's what you've been. That's what Carl.
Those other planets.
That's what Carl Sagan is talking
about. Those other planets. We're going there. But I'm sure there's animal life on those planets right now.
There's entities out there building the planets.
We're not.
There's entities like Thoth out there building the planets on their own out of the ether.
Thoth, huh?
Yes.
Thoth.
Not him. No, he's actually the wisdom. There's other beings higher than him.
So you believe, no, the ancient Egyptians, you know every last pharaoh married a sister, right? So you follow Thoth. It has a lot. So you believe in Thoth, which is an ancient Egyptian philosophy. The ancient Egyptians were also inbred sister
parts. But yeah, they were really higher entities coming down. Even in the Bible, they said the angels raped the women.
It says that the blood says it right before that the men became impure.
And in order to protect the divinity of Jesus Christ, they flooded the earth to cleanse the earth of all those aliens that came down and fucked all the men and fucked up the fucking genetics. Now, a lot of people look at that. A lot of people say that and say, hey, that's the alien coming down. And that's a half truth too.
Just give it a minute.
Is it an alien or is it just a higher truth? Okay. It all makes sense.
Who wrote that book?
I just picked this up today because it had a little truth in it.
You need to go take it back. Get your money back. And go drink that money instead.
I haven't read the tablets 42 times. Man, I'm about to read them over 100 times.
42?
I have no fear. I have no doubt. I'm on a way higher stage of consciousness. I have no fear. I have no doubt.
So what's that book talking about?
This.
You ain't ready. Just
do you know what Krishna is?
Yeah.
Krishna is nothing but one of the Lord of the Cycles.
Krishna.
Yeah, that's the god of destruction. Yeah. On that.
Wait, the Lord of the Cycle, exactly. The cycle.
Well, what year was those scriptures written down? What year?
He said something really important. He said that Krishna was a god of destruction. There's some truth to that.
Krishna is their bootlegged Christ. That's why it sounds similar to Christ.
Let me say one thing. He said something very true. He said Krishna is a god of destruction, right? What it is, Krishna is the Lord of the cycles. So when the earth finishes the cycle after 26,000 years, Krishna is one of the ones in charge of that, and he brings forth the new cycle.
So you believe that, but you don't believe the Bible.
It is
bugged out shit you talking.
The Bible has right, because I can. It's all proven. I can go right and look.
It's
all,
proven.
This is all to the laws of physics and everything. I mean, all the laws of physics back up all
so
the shit
Krishna
that we're
got
writing.
Blue skin, you right?
Everything comes from light.
No, Krishna got blue skin. You tell me.
To do with the price
no so you telling me.
The Bible has been changed 100 times. You're telling me, you're reading out of that.
When was the Vedic scriptures and Mahabharata?